Hey guys, what's up? Welcome to Show It Better. Welcome to this new year, 2018. It's gonna be the bomb. It's gonna be the best. And today I want to bring you a quick video for all of you SketchUp beginners and V-Ray beginners on how to use V-Ray for SketchUp. Now, these are the basic tools, you know, how to get around SketchUp. So if you're a little more advanced, you may want to come back to another video. But today we are going to see the basic tools and how to get a basic render once you installed your V-Ray for SketchUp. It's specifically V-Ray 3.4. So as you guys here, I can have my 3D model here. Remember, you guys, it's always good to have good detailed 3D models with good materials. And V-Ray for SketchUp comes with three main toolbars. Here I am taking them out so you guys can see them better. First one is called V-Ray for SketchUp, which has like the basic settings tool. So you guys here can see your asset editor, where you have four basic spaces, right? The material space, where you will always have like some little arrows that open up more and more windows. So you have the material space, where you have different materials that you can get from here. You guys can see here, the basic V-Ray for SketchUp comes with a lot of materials that the majority of them are pretty good and they have all the settings, right? So if you put the grass, majority of the grass is going to look, you know, good. You have the lighting space, where if I have a sunlight, the plain light, and interior light, I can modify them from here, their intensity, their color, etc. You have the objects, where for example I have here some V-Ray fur for the grass, but you can modify many things here. And the settings, where you put out how big the image is going to be, where it's going to save, how much of a quality it's going to have, the whole environment, and many, many more things, right? So this is the asset editor. In here you will be the majority of the time. Then we have the light toolbar. So in this toolbar you guys can put your different kinds of lights, like plain lights, sphere lights, spotlights, IES lights, Omni lights, etc., etc., etc. So this is all about lights, and this one is all about objects. So as you guys can see, it's the V-Ray fur, the mesh clipper, and infinite plane, and the proxies, right? So in future videos we will see each tool more specifically, but right now, because you guys just installed this, I will teach you guys like the basic tools. So here I have my model. Let's say I haven't have anything done. This button, this little button that says render, you guys just click it and it will start to render. You guys can see here, it says V-Ray Bootstrap, parsing geometry. And as you guys can see, sometimes if the model is very big, it can get a little bit slow. And as soon as I click the render button, this window comes up. This window is called the frame buffer, right? So it's where you guys can see the process of the render of the image being rendered. And you will have a second window. It's called the progress window. You guys can see here in what part of the process the image is in and how much of the process is left, right? So some of it's very technical information that you guys will never pay attention to if you're a beginner. And some of it, you know, it really helps you out. So for example, this is the image I was rendering before I started making the video, but right now this is the image it is starting to render right now, right? That's the view I have, etc. So I can make this window bigger or smaller. And here it says building like J, right? So since I have the image size, you guys can see it over here, it's 1929 by 2411. Since it's a big size, it's going to take a while. I'm not going to wait a lot for it, but this is to show you guys that just by hitting the render button, you know, the image starts to render. There are different types of render styles and the ways you can render this, but this is probably the best one. But let's continue. So let's say we want to, apart from rendering, you guys want to define the image size and how good of a quality the image is going to have. So you go here to the asset editor, and where this we have this symbol, you guys are going to go to quality. If you guys can see right now, I have it in quality medium. You guys can put it in low, draft, where if I put it in draft, it's gonna render much faster, but the quality is gonna be much lower. Or I can put it in very high and it's going to take much more time to render, but the quality is gonna be very high, right? If I go to render output, I can put the dimensions of the image I want. So I can say 1920, and you guys can see this image change, right? Because the aspect ratio is of a portrait. If I click over here and put widescreen, if I put 1920, it's supposed to say 1080. What? 1920? 1080, yep, that's it. And, or you guys can have it as a square, 1080 by 1080, etc. It really depends on how you want it. So for now, I want it as a portrait mode, and I want the width to be 1920. Yeah, that's fine. I wanna show you guys another option. So if you guys see here above, in render output above image width, you have this tool that says save frame. So what this does is it shows you in this space how the proportion of the image is going to be. So if I activate save frame, you guys will see that these little black bars appear on the side of my image, right? Like what's inside the black bars is how the image is going to look. So for example, if I change this to one square, you guys are going to see how my image is going to change, right? Or if I change it to 4:5 portrait, the ratio, it's going to render it that way. So for example, if I'm going to render it in a widescreen mode, and I think that is perfect for me. So with this in mind, you guys can render and save the image. But what I want to do, what I normally do for my images, because the majority of my work is done in Photoshop, I go here to render elements, right? If you guys here are here in this space, you will have this render elements option. And here, you will click add render element and you will have different options, right? So each of these options is a channel, right? Like a different image that you're going to render with the main image that is going to help you in the post-production add a little bit more reality to it or whatever you want to add. So what I always do is select the material ID, and I go over here again, select the object ID, I go over here again and select the render ID. So this is going to take an image of, create a separate image with the materials in different colors. So when I import them to Photoshop, I can modify the materials much easier and I don't have to spend much time modifying each one. So now let's say I want to change the color of this white facade. What I'm going to do is I am going to select the wall. I'm going to click the component, select the wall, and I'm going to right click and press select all with same material. So it's going to select everything that has the same white material. And with having it selected, I'm going to go to my asset editor, which I already have it open. And I'm going to go to the materials part, right? Now I'm going to click here in this open menu of the materials, and I'm going to find a material I want to apply to it. So for example, let's say I want some bricks. You guys here can change the size of what you want to see. So right now it's just a white wall. Let's say I want these bricks, right? So it says bricks weathered E02 1M means 1 meter. So I'm going to select this and drag it over here to material list. Once it's here to the material list, it's going to be in your model, right? So I'm gonna let it go, and now you guys can see here a preview of how the material is set up. Now I'm going to right click here and press apply materials to selection. Once I do this, you guys will see here that now my white walls are just bricks on them. They are very, very small bricks, and they don't look according to the proportion. So as you guys can see here, these images are supposed to be 1 meter big. So how do we do to verify this? We minimize this window and we go up to our materials part. And as you guys can see here in my materials, bricks weathered, it says 0.25 meters. That's the dimension. So it's very small. So what we're going to do is select this window and just click one and press tab. And it's going automatically going to change it, and it's going to make it bigger. Now it is in the right proportion, and we can go back to our scene because that is how we want it to be rendered, right? That's perfect for me. Now you guys can do this with any of the materials that are applied here. Now we can go back to our asset editor. I think that's it. We can click on the render option. Now for your final render, it is gonna take a little while, but at the end, it's worth it. Okay guys, so the render took about an hour or so because my computer is very slow. As you guys can see, I already imported the render into Photoshop. I haven't done anything to it. You know, it was a good render. Some details need to be worked out, like the grass, you know, the car over there looks a little bit weird. That asphalt looks very weird as well. So I imported it with, the material ID and the object ID channel, because as I was telling you guys, with these channels you can separate the windows, the walls, the grass, and change it all in Photoshop. I'm not going to show the Photoshop process I did, but I can show you guys how the final image looked. This is more or less how the final image looked. I imported grass, trees in the background, the sky. I added some light adjustments. It wasn't the perfect result that I wanted, but you know, it serves a purpose. So if you guys want to look at this PSD file more in detail, you can download it in the description. But for now, I'm just gonna leave it here. I hope you guys liked this video. In the future, I want to do more specific advanced tutorials on V-Ray. I know this was a very beginner, you know, this is for people that are just starting in V-Ray and just wanted to do the basic render. So I hope you guys like this video. Remember to subscribe, share, and like this video. Thank you guys. Have a happy new year. I hope this year is the bomb for you guys. And thank you for watching. See you guys later. Bye.